Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and Assalamu alaikum dear students. In this lecture we will learn about the history of computers, means how the computer is developed by the time and how the changes are occurred. The learning outcomes of this lesson are as follows, and I am pretty sure that after this lecture you will be able to know about the evolution of the computer. You will be able to describe the brief history and generation of computers, and you will be able to define and differentiate the types and classification of computer. The history of computer was started about 3000 BC with the abacus. It's just a manual calculation machine using number of beads, which was divided into two parts, upper and lower within a frame. It could use for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division operations. After the many years, in 17th century, a mechanical computing device was introduced. The device, which was based on manual inputs, worked on motions and outputs manually. After 1890, the discovery of the electron made it possible to convert this technology, and the scientists were succeed to develop an electronic circuit. This technology was based in that era was called electronic relay, and it's basically a switch which is capable to pass the current when it's on and shuts the flow of current when it's off. This method gave birth to the binary number system, and then advancement of this technology developed first automatic sequence control calculator, or also it is called Mark I. After 1940, the vacuum tubes were replaced by this technology and the era of first generation started. Meanwhile, from 16th to 18th century, the respective devices were developed. Napier's bone. It was invented by John Napier in 1614. It consists of wooden box, rotating cylinders having 0 to 9 digit, and it could perform multiplication and division and even find the square root with the help of rods. Pascaline. It was invented by Blaise Pascal in 1642. Each wheel of the Pascaline had 10 parts having digits 0 to 9. When one wheel completes a rotation, the next wheel moves by one digit. It had a number of small slots for displaying the result. It could perform addition and subtraction on whole numbers only. The next is slide rule. It was invented by William Otter in 1920s, and it was based on the Napier's ideas about logarithm. It consists of two scales, the rule and slide, and the transparent moving piece of cursor. It could perform addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Hollerith desk. Hermann Hollerith built tabulating machine in 1890. It consisted of a card reader which sensed the holes in cards, a gate driven mechanism which could count, and a large set of dial indicators to display the results. It was invented to help with the census in 1890 in America. In this slide, I will explain about the generation of computers, means how the computers revolutionary become modernized and the computers which we use nowadays. The first generation starts from 1940 40s till 1956, almost 16 years of tenure. The second generation starts from 1956 till 63, almost 7 to 8 years of tenure. The third generation starts from 1964 till 71, almost 7 to 8 years of tenure. And the fourth generation starts from 1977 till 2020, almost 50 years of tenure. In every era, the aim was to speed up and reduce the size and the cost of computer. But now the target is to take decision using artificial intelligence, because the present computers cannot take its own decision and they are dependent on users' input or instructions. Now, high performance computing is being used for parallel processing, running advanced application programs efficiently, reliably, and fast. Similarly, cloud computing, which means storing and accessing data programs over the internet instead of computer's storage device. So fifth generation starts from present till beyond. And the scientists are trying to make the robots which could use artificial intelligence technology. Computers type depend upon the architecture design and working, which differ on the type of data that enters into it and the form of its output. Analog computer takes input from the environment as a physical quantity such as temperature, pressure, and speed, etc. And after processing, it produces results in the form of continuous wave or graph. Whereas digital computer represents data in the form of discrete. Hybrid computer combines the features, best features of analog as well as digital computer. They are special purpose computers. These computers are fast and more accurate than analog and digital computers. And these hybrid computers helps the user to handle both analog and digital data at the same time. And the application or the area where it can be used are in scientific applications, monitoring industrial process and hospitals, etc. Moreover, digital computers are classified into the following subgroups based on their processing power or speed, physical and memory size, and other capabilities or features of the computer. Microcomputer, mini computer, and mainframe computer. Whereas supercomputer is classified into the hybrid type. Hope that you have enjoyed the lecture. Kindly go through it again and your text which is given in your book. Thanks a lot. Have a nice day. Allah Hafiz.